That means we're on. By golly.
Didn't realize. Hello, now we're here.
We're all here.
We have 2 minutes. At 12:58. Well, that's our time. It would depend on where you reside.
Exactly.
Oh, Dan Wolking greets all. Hi,
hey,
Dan.
Hey, brother. How
welcome,
are you?
Welcome.
Sure enjoyed talking with you yesterday.
Yes. I didn't really, but I would have. I didn't get to.
You were busy.
Yeah.
Taking care of vital and necessary things. Like feeding our daughter and stuff.
Yes, because she came back for lunch, which was very nice. Well, let's see, Ziggy. Yeah. Harp Dust is here.
Hello, Ziggy.
Hello, George and Lynn. Greetings from Germany.
Welcome. I hope the weather has improved since Ivan's concert last Sunday when Ziggy was having rather severe thunderstorms over there.
It is now 1.
All right. Well, welcome everybody.
Yes.
I'm glad you could come by for our 21st. I can't believe.
Oh, I know.
That we've we've not only that we've done it this long, but the people put up with it this long.
Oh, we've had a great time.
We have.
This has been a wonderful
almost every minute of it since show number 9. The first 8 were kind of ragged. But anyway, I'm playing the harp with the new strings. And I sent out the invitations Thursday and got all of that done and was practicing and broke a fingernail. Which is not a good thing for a bare-knuckle player like I am. But I limped along, and then yesterday, I broke another one. So, I am playing with finger picks today, which is something I very rarely do, so things may not be quite as precise as they have been. We'll just have to see. I don't know if you can see these, but I'm using Alaska finger picks, and I'll talk more about those here in a little while. The when we get some more auto harpers in here.
Yes.
The topic today, or the theme, the title of the show is Remember When, and we're going to take a look back, a nostalgic look back into the past, and hope you enjoy it. Hope you're old enough to remember some of these things so that I'm not the only one in this age group. But anyway, this song was recorded by Kenny Rogers in 1984 or 5, and it's called 20 Years Ago. And it's a look back. It's a story about a fellow who comes back to his old hometown. How can it be your old hometown? Anyway, comes back to his hometown after 20 years, and this is what he remembers. It's been a long time since I walked through this old town. Oh, how the memories start to flow. There's the old movie house, they finally closed it down. You could find me there every Friday night 20 years ago. I worked the counter at the drugstore down the street. nobody's left there I would know. But Saturday morning, that's where all my friends would meet. You'd be surprised what a dime could buy 20 years ago. All my memories from those days come gather round me. What I'd give if they could take me back in time. Oh, it almost seems like yesterday. Where do the good times roll? Life was so much easier 20 years ago. I guess I should stop by Mr. Johnson's hardware store. His only son was my friend Joe. But he joined the army back in 1964. How could we know he would never come back 20 years ago? All my memories from those days come gather round me. What I'd give if they could take me back in time. Oh, it almost seems like yesterday. Where do the good times roll? Life was so much easier 20 years ago. Oh, it almost seems like yesterday, 20 years ago.
Wow. Ziggy says, the storm last Sunday was first rather timid, but returned around midnight with heavy wind and rain. This morning we had some rain, and now it is much cooler than the past days, more agreeable. And we have Deborah Lynn Brace McGinnis with us. She says, hi, guys.
Hi, Debbie. Hi. Thanks for coming by.
She said, nice job, George. That was lovely.
Thank you. Wonderful to see you again.
Yes. And Ziggy said, over here in Germany, most houses don't have AC, me neither. And my flat is right below the roof.
Oh, that could get a little bit warm in the summertime, I should think. I was raised without air conditioning. I guess the first home that we had that was air conditioned was when we moved down here in 1984.
Mm-hmm. I think you're right.
And
but the humidity in the south here
is
so
very
bad.
High, it's, usually. Today it isn't. It's a wonderful day today. It's like 76, and very low humidity. And if it were up to me, I still wouldn't run air conditioning. But
Robert C. Richmond is here. He said, obviously you don't need your fingernails for your voice to shine. Beautiful, nostalgic song. Thank you again. Thanks again.
Thank you, Robert. Thank you very much. These are Alaska finger picks. They were discussed on the Autoharp Facebook group and I think also on the Cyberpluckers mailing list. And if you are or were a Bare Nails player, these are the best finger picks I've ever found for people who, like me, have played all our lives with Bare Nails. Because they fit over the nail, and there's a little piece that actually goes under your nail. So, you know, you have to have a little bit of a nail. But they stay put. They absolutely stay put. They don't go flying off. And if you, like I did, break the nail back far enough that you can't catch the little flange, then you use Hal Weeks's tip about the next care tape. And I'm telling you what, if you're a finger picker, you want some of this stuff. It almost feels like skin. It's called NexCare, N-E-X-C-A-R-E, waterproof tape. And boy, I put just one round around the tip of this finger right here, because this pick doesn't want to stay. And that pick stays put. No rubbing the cuticles raw anymore or anything. That's the best tip I've heard in a long time. Anyway.
Robert says, kudos to Ziggy. He does have a nice lake at his doorstep to moderate the climate. Great climate for his Autoharp music.
Yes, indeed. And by the way, you should, if you haven't already done so, you should check out Ziggy's YouTube channel. He's got some really good tunes over there. He's a good Autoharp player. I can get him to do a live stream of his own one of these days. The more the merrier. Here is a song by a group called the Statler Brothers. And it's called Do You Remember These?
Carol Ann Hodgson Allen.
Hello, great, Carol.
Great info regarding the picks. Thanks.
Good. I'm glad. I hope you can put it to use, pass it along. I may convert to them, because you can play forever and not have to worry about your nails. Let me try that one more time. Saturday morning serials, chapters 1 through 15. Fly paper, penny loafers, lucky strike green. Flat tops, sock hop, Studebaker, Pepsi please. Do you remember these? Cigar bands on your hand, your daddy's socks roll down. Stick snow plugs and aviator caps with flaps that button down. Movie stars on Dixie cup tops and knickers to your knees. Do you remember these? The hit parade, grape truade, the Sadie Hawkins dance. Pedal pushers, ducktail hair, and peg in your pants. Howdy doody, tooty fruity, and the seam up the back of her hose. Do you remember those? James Dean, he was keen, Sunday movies were taboo. Senior prom, Judy's mom, rock and roll was new. Cracker Jack prize, stars in your eyes, ask daddy for the keys. Do you remember these? The boogeyman, lemonade stand, and taking your tonsils out. Indian burn, wait your turn, and four foul balls you're out. Cigarette loads and secret codes and saving lucky stars. Can you remember back that far? To boat neck shirts, fender skirts, and crinoline petticoats. Mum's the word and a dirty bird and a double root beer float. Moon hub caps and loud heel taps, and he's a real gone cat. Do you remember that? Dancing close, little moron jokes and cooties in her hair. Captain Midnight, Ovaltine, and the whip at the county fair. Charles Atlas course, Roy Rogers horse, and only the shadow knows. Do you remember those? Gable's charm, frog in your arm, lard mufflers, pitching woo. Going steady, Veronica and Betty, white bucks and blue suede shoes. Knock, knock jokes. Who's there? Dewey. Dewey who? Do we remember these? Yes, we do. Oh, do we remember these?
I remember.
I remember a lot of that, which makes me feel really old.
Nancy Beatty is here. Hi, good
hey,
to
Nancy.
See you. Hi, Nan. That's my sister.
Yes, indeed. Thank you for coming by. Hope
yes.
Things are going well your way.
Yes. Oh, and Ziggy has, thanks for the compliment, George. Also, in recent times, I didn't find time for new videos on my channel. And so he has a YouTube channel posted here, a link. And Hillary Robinson is here. Hi,
hello,
George.
Hillary.
Hi, George and Lynn. I'm having a cup of tea just now because I don't have a proper copper coffee.
Well, we'll have to work on that.
Yes.
Oh, people seem to get a kick out of that.
I love that one. Yes.
I was just waiting for a challenge that would allow me to post some of my comedy songs over there. I've got a couple others I'm going to inflict on
that. It's hard to narrow it down, you know.
Well, there's that. Here's a song that was done by Jimmy Buffett. And it's another kind of batch of memory songs from the 50s, mostly. And it's called Pencil Thin Mustache. Now they make new movies in all black and white, with happy endings where nobody fights. So if you find yourself in that nostalgic rage, honey, jump right up and show your age. I wish I had a pencil-thin mustache, the Boston Blackie kind, a two-tone Ricky Ricardo jacket and an autographed picture of Andy Devine. Well, I remember being buck-toothed and skinny, writing fan letters to Skye's niece Penny. Well, I wish I had a pencil-thin mustache, then I could solve some mysteries too. Well, bandstand Disneyland, growing up fast, drinking on a fake ID. Well, Rama of the jungle was everyone's Bwana, and only jazz musicians were smoking marijuana. Well, I wish I had a pencil-thin mustache, then I could solve some mysteries too. Rubbing on the living room floor, so sore. They send you off to college just to gain a little knowledge, when all you want to do is learn how to score. Well, now I'm getting old, I don't wear underwear, I don't go to church, and I don't cut my hair, cause I can go to movies and see it all there, just the way that it used to be. That's why I wish I had a pencil-thin mustache, the Boston Blackie kind, a two-tone Ricky Ricardo jacket and an autographed picture of Andy Devine. Well, I could be anyone I wanted to be, maybe Suave Errol Flynn or the Sheik of Araby. If I only had a pencil-thin mustache, then I could do some cruising to Brill Cream, a little dabble, do ya? I could do some cruising too. That song came out right around the time that movies like Grease and Animal House and movies like that that were kind of looking back on that time, and it was kind of Jimmy's way of poking fun at those.
Yeah.
Movies, so it's a little bit obscure, but it's got a catchy tune.
It
so.
Does. Lois Conklin is here. She says, so fun. Thank you for sharing.
Thank you, Lois.
And Carol Welcome. Ann Hodgson Allen, wish I could stay for this whole show. I'll have to catch it later off the live feed. You guys are great.
Well, thanks for stopping by, Carol. And yes, indeed, it will be up there. So please do rejoin us when you can, and have a great day. Okay. Still.
Lois said, fun song. Never heard it before. Thank you.
Glad you liked it. Here is a song.
And Ziggy said, a very funny song. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
It's one of my favorites. It is.
Yeah. I didn't hear the Jimmy Buffett version until like just a few days ago. A group that we used to love when we were in college did it called, the group's name was A Touch of Grass. They did one album and one album only.
It's really hard to find.
And you can't find it anywhere.
Can't find it.
At least we haven't been able to. And that's where I learned it. But they got it from Jimmy Buffett. And the Barnyard Dance song, Lynn, that we liked so much is actually a Steve Goodman song.
Really?
Yeah. So.
Well, origins are interesting.
Yes, indeed. Here's a song that was actually done in the late 50s, I don't know exactly when, by a group called the Four Lads. And it's called Moments to Remember. January to December, we'll have these moments to remember. Ooh, the New Year's Eve, we did the town. The day we tore the goalposts down, we will have these moments to remember. The quiet walks, the noisy fun, the ballroom prize we almost won. We will have these moments to remember. When summer turns to winter and the present disappears, the laughter we were glad to share will echo through the years. When other nights and other days may find us gone our separate ways, we will have these moments to remember. The drive-in where we used to go, till now we never watch the show. We will have these moments to remember. When summer turns to winter and the present disappears, the laughter we were glad to share will echo through the years. When other nights and other days may find us gone our separate ways, we will have these moments to remember.
Wow.
I just recently, I used to work at a radio station behind the scenes. I did all their computer work, wrote their software, and it was an easy listening station. And they used to play that song a lot. And they played that 20 years ago song a lot, too. Because mm-hmm. most of the people were old and they loved to look back on stuff. But you know what? Old people got all the money. And we got a lot of it.
That's a good point, yeah.
Okay. Let's see what else we can come up with. Ah, yes. Here's a song that will make you feel old, if anything can. It's done by the Bellamy Brothers. They're a country music group that was popular over here for a good many years. And it's called An Old Hippie. He turned 35 last Sunday. In his hair he found some gray. But he still ain't changed his lifestyle. He likes it better the old way. So he grows a little garden in the backyard by the fence. He's consuming what is growing nowadays, it's self-defense. He gets out there in the twilight zone sometimes when things just don't make no sense. He gets off on country music, 'cause disco left him cold. He's got young friends in the new wave, but he's just too freaking old. And he dreams at night of Woodstock and the day John Lennon died. How the music made him happy and the silence made him cry. Yeah, he thinks of John sometimes, and he has to wonder why. He's an old hippie and he don't know what to do. Should he hang on to the old? Should he grab onto the new? He's an old hippie and this new life is just a bust. He ain't trying to change nobody. He's just trying real hard to adjust. He was sure back in the 60s that everyone was hip. Then they sent him off to Vietnam on his senior trip. And they forced him to become a man while he was still a boy. After each new wave of tragedy, he waited for the joy. Though the world may change around him, he just can't change no more. He's an old hippie and he don't know what to do. Should he hang on to the old? Should he grab onto the new? He's an old hippie and this new life is just a bust. He ain't trying to change nobody. He's just trying real hard to adjust. Now he stays away more often from the parties and the clubs. And he's thinking while he's jogging round, he sure is glad he quit the hard drugs. 'Cause him and his kind grow more endangered every day. And someday soon the species will just up and fade away. Like the smoke from that torpedo, just up and fade away. He's an old hippie and he don't know what to do. Should he hang on to the old? Should he grab onto the new? He's an old hippie and this new life is just a bust. He ain't trying to change nobody. He's just trying real hard to adjust. No, he ain't trying to change nobody. He's just trying real hard to adjust.
We have Philippa has joined us. Philippa Alderton.
Hey, Philippa.
Says, hey, guys. And Ivan Stiles.
Hello, Ivan.
He says, hi, Lynn and George. Finally got here. I was working on my program for tomorrow, and 2 o'clock went whizzing by.
Well, I understand that.
And Ziggy says, the old hippie song by the Bellamy's was a moderate success on the German charts.
Uh-huh.
And Philippa said, may vanish house guests, sugar is being annoying. Oh, my. I can't think something happened.
It helps if you can actually read what's written there.
May vanish. House guest sugar is being annoying.
Hmm.
Okay. And Ivan Stiles, what was the very funny song I missed? Oh, that was, which one was this before this one?
Oh, the Pencil Thin Mustache by Jimmy Buffett, I think, is the one.
Or the copper coffee pot song that was mentioned.
Yeah, that was on the UK Autoharp group.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you don't already know about it, Ivan does a concert every Sunday. He's braver than I am. I can only manage him every other week, but he's a professional, man. He can knock them out, and it's great music and a lot of fun. It's kind of a lot like the format here. Miss Nancy reads his comments out, which is really helpful to me. Because I don't see them otherwise. And he plays really great music, and he plays, sometimes he'll even haul out different instruments other than the autoharps that he has. So if you haven't had a chance to check Ivan's concerts out, go to the Ivan Stiles Facebook page tomorrow at 2 Eastern, and you'll be in for a real treat. I'll tell you that right now.
Well, I want to say to Philip, I hope your house guest is going to be okay.
Indeed.
Our thoughts are with that person.
All right, here's a song that should be fairly interesting. I've never heard it on the autoharp before, and after this, you may never want to hear it again. Frank Sinatra had a hit with this back in 1965. It's called A Very Good Year.
I have one from Ivan, says, but your programs are 2 hours long. Mine are only 1 hour. Thanks for the plug.
Hey, no problem. Always glad to help. We need more online people.
Yes.
I was doing this before the COVID crisis, and I'll be doing it after that. So I hope some of the other people who are doing great programs now will find the time to keep giving them to us once in a while. When I was 17, it was a very good year. It was a very good year for small town girls and soft summer nights. We'd hide from the lights on the village green. When I was 17, it was a very good year. It was a very good year for city girls who lived up the stair with perfumed hair that came undone. When I was 21, oh, 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 when I was 35, It was a very good year. It was a very good year for blue-blooded girls of independent means. We'd ride in limousines. Their chauffeurs would drive. When I was 35, and now the days grow short. I'm in the autumn of the year, and I think of my life as vintage wine from fine old caves, from the brim to the dregs. It poured sweet and clear. It was a very good year. Oh, 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 oh.
I love that one. I love that song.
I actually got through it.
You did.
Usually I miss a chord or two in that one. So I'm glad if it was going to come together that it did so now.
Now, yes.
And
did you say Frank Sinatra?
He had a hit with it back in 1965. I don't know who originally did it. Everybody in Creations recorded it.
Yes.
The problem I'm having today is that I think about these picks because it doesn't feel right, and then my concentration slips, so I have to work on that. Okay. Here is a song that was done by a very obscure Yankee bluegrass group. You don't see or hear too many of those. Most of them are Southerners, but these guys are, I think, from Massachusetts. They're called the Good Brothers, and this is a tune of theirs that I really like a lot. It's called Old Mullins Hill. It's been 50 rough years since I was a kid, though it seems like it was just yesterday. When I think back on the things that we did, I can still hear the laughter as we used to play. The boys and the girls, we'd all go swimming. We had our own way of getting the thrill. The boys were not men, and the girls were not women, so we'd go in naked back at Old Mullins Hill. Thank God for the memories, they bring us such joy. Reminds me of days when I was a boy. We laughed and we played till we had our fill. We'd swim and have fun back at Old Mullins Hill. Sometimes we'd play hooky and the boys would go fishing for catfish and shiners at the old fishing hole. To land us the big ones, we all be dreaming with a safety pin hook and an old bamboo pole. On the way home, we'd take a shortcut down through the orchard past Charlie the Bull. He'd always come running, but he'd never catch us. And we'd eat green apples until we were full. Thank God for the memories, they bring us such joy. Reminds me of days when I was a boy. We laughed and we played till we had our fill. We'd We'd swim and have fun back at old Mullins Hill. Like cowboys and Indians, we'd track down each other with a homemade bow and arrow and a Roy Rogers gun. My posse was me, my dog and my brother, the outlaws and rustlers, we captured each one. Thank God for the memories, they bring us such joy. Reminds me of days when I was a boy. We laughed and we played till we had our fill. We'd swim and have fun back at old Mullins Hill.
Nice.
Old Mullins Hill.
Yeah. Ziggy said there is a Good Brothers Bluegrass Band from Canada.
That might be them, actually, Ziggy.
In which Bruce Good plays also autoharp. And there's a link to it. Thank you.
Oh, thanks for the link. Yeah, I'm going to check that out. It might be the same group. I found this song while I was looking for something else about a year and a half ago on YouTube. And I grabbed everything I had that they had on YouTube at that time. They're a great group. Check them out. And I will look at that. I'll bet it's the same group. I was just guessing on their being from Massachusetts by their accent.
So it
tells you how my ear for accents is.
Well, north, you had north.
Yeah, I had that right. Damn Yankees. Here's a song that I did once before, but it fits the theme.
Oh, Nan said very nice on that.
Thank you, Nan. Thank you very much. I did this song once before. It's a Judd Strunk tune called Bill Jones General Store. I'm doing it again, not only because it fits the theme, but because it brings back a memory of when I was a young man. We had a general store down home that was very much like that, like the one I'm going to sing about. It was called Miller's General Store. Ivan W. and his wife, Minnie. Eileen.
Flip said, folks around here sound very Canadian at times. The accents tend to overlap.
That's true.
And Ziggy said, the Good Brothers played a few gigs in Germany and Switzerland, so I know them personally.
Oh. Wow.
And Flip said, remember the store. Yeah. I do too.
Yeah, yeah. You were down there when they were still open.
Yes.
And it was like that. If Ivan and Eileen didn't have it, you don't need it.
You didn't need it.
And Ivan could get you stuff. He could get you a few firecrackers for the 4th of July. He could even lay his hands on dynamite from time to time if you had a stubborn stump or a rock or something you just had to get out of your field. of course, I had a different way of doing that, but we'll go into that at another time. But anyway, this song, every time I hear it or play it, I think of that place because it's just like this. It was a wonderful place, and they ran it until Ivan passed away, and Eileen sold it to my sister and brother-in-law, in fact.
Yes, I remember. Flip said amazing what they had. It was.
It truly was.
All the stuff.
If you and
a real general store is what it was.
It really was. I mean, you could buy coveralls. You could buy
horseshoes.
Horseshoes. You could buy a gallon of milk. If you needed a really odd bolt, right. Ivan probably had it somewhere back in there.
Right.
He was a rock hound. He had a tumbler, and
yes.
He'd go out and he'd collect rocks and he'd polish them and he'd sell them, or he'd put them in settings and sell them. They were, and he was a whaling good banjo player when his arthritis wasn't acting up too. Anyway, here's the song that makes me think of them. And,
Case Knives also.
Case Knives.
That's true.
Yeah. Corncob pipes, kinds of things. I still got a jacket that I bought from him years ago. There was a wooden sign on the highway just outside of Stratton, Maine. It said, "If we ain't got it, you don't need it. Bill Jones, General Store." I can hear the creaking of the rusty old screen door. Smell the penny candy at Bill Jones General Store. Pipe smoke and tobacco, wet boots on the floor. Campbell's soup and shotgun shells at Bill Jones General Store. The cold and snow would blow against the glassed in window pane. The old wood stove would kindle and try to dry the rain. I know the times are changing, but it won't be the same. Now the doors are bolted, Bill and Ruth are gone from town. The rooms are cold and empty, they'll probably tear it down. But Herky, Wright, and Whitey still sit outside the door, waiting for that quart of beer at Bill Jones General Store. I can hear the creaking of the rusty old screen door. Smell the penny candy at Bill Jones General Store. Pipe smoke and tobacco, wet boots on the floor. Campbell's soup and shotgun shells at Bill Jones General Store. Campbell's soup and shotgun shells at Bill Jones General Store.
Yeah, that's amazing. Because that's so much like that.
Yeah.
Was.
It was the place to go. And Ivan was also a crack shot. Mm-hmm. He had some punk kids come up there one night about midnight, going to rip him off and beat him to death. And Ivan whipped out his trusty long rifle, and to hear him tell it, he had them stepping and dancing, and they were doing a real good job of it, too. He could hit anything he could see.
Ivan said, "Tom Fladmark wrote a song about a general store he knew that was torn down to make room for the Susquehanna Mall." Can't remember the name. Same flavor. And Philip
wonder
said,
if it's out there anywhere, Ziggy. I'd love to learn it.
Yeah. Philip said, yeah, a lot like Miller's.
Yep. Yep.
So, but yeah, that sounds like an interesting song there.
Okay. Here's a song that's all over the Autoharp keyboard, so I don't know how it's going to come out. It was done by the Kingston Trio, and it's called "That's How I Remember Yesterday." Sometimes I stop and think about the way things used to be when I was just a kid out on the street. Everything was simple then, at least it seemed that way. So when life gets more than I can take, my thoughts go racing back to yesterday. When Detroit put steel in every car, freeways didn't come through yards. To put two arms around a girl was going pretty far. A little seemed a lot to us, but people seemed to have more trust, and that's how I remember yesterday. When I never walked, I always ran. My first bike was second hand, and anything worth having came for free. There were times when times were tough, but people seem to have enough, and that's how I remember yesterday. And now the years go by so fast, friendships come and go, the The world today is different than before. But lovers still walk hand in hand. The good things haven't changed. Love still makes the world go round. And that's how I remember yesterday. We looked up to cops and down on crooks. Fished with last year's fishing hooks. I never feared the darkness when I woke up in the night. Cause the rumble of a distant train would put me back to sleep again. And that's how I remembered yesterday. We had fields to fly our paper kites. Picture shows on Friday nights. Basketball on Saturdays. I always got to play. A dime back then was worth a quarter. Mother was a name to honor. And that's how I remember yesterday. When Detroit put steel in every car, freeways didn't come through yards. To put two arms around a girl was going pretty far. A little seemed a lot to us, but people seem to have more trust. And that's how I remember yesterday. That's how I remember yesterday.
Lulu came over to visit me. Here she comes to see you. There she is.
Hey, Lulu. Hi, everybody. Lulu says hi to everybody.
Yes.
My faithful guide dog, who unfortunately is nearing the end of her career. She's developing a vision problem. And that's kind of ironic, isn't it? That a guide dog would have to retire because your vision is failing. I don't know the technical name for it, but the lenses, her inner eyes are clouding over. They're not cataracts. There's nothing can be done about it. So there you go. I know.
She's slowed down a bit.
Yeah, she has, and she's
I think so. That she's still willing. It's just that she can't do the job.
She will,
like she could.
She will have a nice retirement and get to be a pet and go run and play outside with the other dogs and do things that she's never been allowed to do before. Heck, we
and
might
wants
even,
to do, go play with Sadie. And
yeah, we might even let her get up on the couch. I don't know.
Play with old Oreo.
Yeah. There's a dog behind us. He's black and white, and the kids back there named him Oreo.
Right. He's figured out how to get over in our yard.
He can get under the fence somewhere, and I think he would like to be our dog, so I have to be very careful.
Right.
Hi, you know, dogs get lots of neat stuff over here, and all I get is yelled at.
Ivan says, Lulu, so sad.
Yeah, well.
But she'll get to be a dog.
She'll get to be a dog, and
right.
And it happens. I yeah. know what it must be like to be immortal. As each family that you raise ages and dies, I've been
yeah.
through this 6 times before.
With guide dogs.
And it's like losing a part of you. It really is, as you
yeah.
watch them. And all you can do is, you know, have a drink or two in their memory and then think with hope to the next puppy.
Right.
So I'm working on that. Anyway, here is another Statler Brothers tune. That Linda actually likes and requested. It's called Maple Street Memories. Let's see here. We were just 9 years old when you came to town. I remember the big Allied van. My mama went over and took you all lunch. And my dad gave your dad a hand. The first time I saw you was through the screen door. when the paper I threw missed the porch. Lord, it's been years since I carried the news, but I still carry the torch. Maple Street memories and cherry tree games, summer nights and ice cream cones. Take the red from the roses, the sun from the sky, but leave my Maple Street memories alone. Leave my Maple Street memories alone. We'd play hide and seek in the buildings out back. I was easy to find, I admit. And as the years flew away, I found it harder to hide the fact that I thought you were it. We stood by the lilac bush in your backyard, your pink prom gown in late May. Your mom took our picture, I took your hand, and you took my breath away. Maple Street memories and cherry tree games, summer nights and ice cream cones. Take the red from the roses, the sun from the sky, but leave my Maple Street memories alone. But leave my Maple Street memories alone. I never go back. I don't stand in the yard, look at your window upstairs. In my mind I see you combing your hair and blowing kisses at me in the air. Then one time at Christmas I saw you come home, your arms full of children that day. And later that night, when I put mine to bed, I put my Maple Street memories away. Maple Street memories and cherry tree games, summer nights and bicycle days. Leave me with something my heart can take, but take those Maple Street memories away. Take those Maple Street memories away.
Ivan says, I had a dog named Lulu when I was a kid. She thought she was a Cocker Spaniel. And our son-in-law, Charles Benjamin Harris, has joined us. He says, hey, I'm late, but I'm here. So hi, Ben.
Welcome.
Welcome. Good to have you.
Hope you all get your air conditioning
fixed soon. Well, they have a small unit right now.
Well, that's better than nothing.
I'm hoping.
I'm glad you could come by, Benji, for sure.
Yeah, good.
Have to get together here one of these days.
You have Lulu back. She's interfering. Dog.
That's all. No, that's all.
She says, no, I want some attention.
Here's a Gordon Lightfoot tune called Did she mention my name? Hopefully Lulu will let me play it here.
Stop playing buttons and strings. Yes, stop
that's right.
Playing buttons.
Stop playing buttons.
Yeah.
I hate that. We could be doing something. It's so nice to meet an old friend and pass the time of day and talk about the hometown a million miles away. Is the ice still in the river? Are the old folks still the same? And by the way, did she mention my name? Did she mention my name just in passing? And when the morning came, do you remember if she dropped a name or two? Is the home team still on fire? Do they still win all their games? And by the way, did she mention my name? Is the landlord still a loser? Do his signs hang in the hall? Are the young girls still as pretty in the city in the fall? Does the laughter on their faces still put the sun to shame? And by the way, did she mention my name? Did she mention my name just in passing? And when the talk ran high, did the look in her eye seem far away? Is the old roof still leaking when the big snow turns to rain? And by the way, did she mention my name? Did she mention my name just in passing? And looking at the rain, do you remember if she dropped a name or two? Won't you say hello from someone? There'll be no need to explain. And by the way, did she mention my name?
Like Gordon Lightfoot.
Gordon Lightfoot.
Good old Gordon, yeah.
And here's another song about the old hometown. It's done by a guy named Joe South. It's called Don't It Make You Wanna Go Home. Don't it make you wanna go home now? Don't it make you wanna go home? All God's children get weary when they roam. Don't it make you wanna go home? Don't it make you wanna go home? Whippoorwill roosts on a telephone pole when the Georgia sun goes down. Been a long time, but I'm glad to say I'm going back to my hometown. Going down to the Greyhound station, gonna buy me a one-way fare. The good Lord willing and the creek don't rise, by tomorrow I'll be right there. Don't it make you wanna go home now? Don't it make you wanna go home? All God's children get weary when they roam. And don't it make you wanna go home? Don't it make you wanna go home? But there's a six-lane highway down by the creek where I went skinny dipping as a child. And there's a drive-in show where the meadow used to grow and the strawberries used to grow wild. There's a drag strip down by the riverside where my grandma's cows used to graze. Now the grass don't grow and the river don't flow like it did in my childhood days. Don't it make you want to go home now? Don't it make you want to go home? All God's children get weary when they roam. And don't it make you want to go home? Don't it make you want to go home? Don't it make you want to go home now? Don't it make you want to go home? All God's children get weary when they roam. And don't it make you want to go home? Don't it make you want to go home? Don't it make you want to go home? Can't ever go home.
Nope.
You can never go home because it's not the way it was. Years ago, when Google Earth first came out, Lynn had a friend who was really good with it. And they took me on a tour of my old neighborhood. And it was really not as much fun as I thought it would be. Some things were still there, and a lot of them weren't.
The changes were disturbing.
And, of course, nothing ever stays the same, but it really brought that home to me. You can never go home. Our house, when we owned it, had green stucco on the bottom and white wooden siding on top, and somebody had put all white aluminum siding on it and things like that.
And trees being moved, and of course trees have to be, but I'm thinking of my grandparents' home in Lima and how beautiful it was, and it's not that way now. And probably where I grew up, it's changed, that house, and nobody's there that used to be there. All of it, where it lives is in memory.
My high school was still there.
That's true.
The house of a neighbor that was a very, very good friend of mine, Ed Kohling, his house was still there.
Really? Yeah. I forgot about that.
But anyway, you can't go home.
No, you can't.
And that's what I guess both of those songs are kind of talking about. Okay. You remember that old hippie? Remember him?
I remember that old hippie.
You just can't get rid of that guy.
He didn't know what to do.
He didn't know what to do. He still doesn't.
Doesn't.
This is called Old Hippie, the sequel. He'll turn 45 come Wednesday. His gray hair is getting thin, but he's still hanging in there. Don't feel too bad for the shape he's in. He's seen yuppies in the White House, but he thinks they're gonna fail, 'cause he just don't trust a president who never has inhaled. And he prays to God to stop this crime, but it seems to no avail. He still likes country music. He's been left out in the dark, 'cause they don't play Merle and George no more. He don't know Billy Ray from Garth. And he's heard of Woodstock too, but it never could compete, 'cause he was there the day that Hendrix played the anthem with his feet. Back when all those grunge bands couldn't even keep a beat. He's an old hippie, even older than before, wondering what to pay attention to and what he should ignore. He's an old hippie, still adjusting to the change. He's just trying to find some balance in a world gone totally insane. He still thinks back on the 60s, but in a different way. 'Cause they built a wall to his war and then forgot the MIAs. And he's trying to be a nice man, but it's too much of a bore. 'Cause fax machines and cell phones ain't what he was put here for. In a world selling sex and youth, he's the last old dinosaur. He's an old hippie, even older than before, wondering what to pay attention to and what he should ignore. He's an old hippie, still adjusting to the change. He's just trying to find some balance in a world gone totally insane. He comes on home from work now, takes some time up with the kids, trying to teach them right from wrong. Hopes they don't learn it the way he did. And his eyes are on the future, but it's looking pretty sad. And with every day that passes, he becomes more like his dad. He hopes that when this century turns around, things won't be so bad. He's an old hippie, even older than before, wondering what to pay attention to and what he should ignore. He's an old hippie, still adjusting to the change. He's just trying to find some balance in a world gone totally insane. He's just trying to find some balance in a world that's gone totally insane.
Mike Alford is here.
Hey, Mike.
And says, hi, George.
From the Periscope group. Thank you for looking in on us. I appreciate it, and I appreciate your group. I've heard a lot of great musicians over there.
Ah.
It's all dedicated to online musicians.
Wow.
And I'll tell you what, there are some darn good entertainers over there.
Welcome.
You want to hear some good music, get Mike to let you into that group, buddy. Because everybody's over there.
Oh, and Ziggy says, and he says, I feel very much like this older, old hippie. And I know.
So do I, Ziggy.
And Joe Harrell. Joe's here.
Hey, Joe, welcome.
He says, sort of. I'll watch later. Just wanted to check in. Well, welcome, Joe.
Yeah, by all means, look in on us later on.
Yes.
And have a great day. All right. Here is a song. Again, about how a town can change and all. It's done by a West Virginian and he bills himself as Cathead Johnson. And he sings all about the plight of the impoverished West Virginians and all the different things that happened to him. He sings a song about when a dam broke and then they fixed it, but they didn't do it right. And a year later, they said it couldn't happen again, and it did. You know, stuff like that. So Cathead's not the most cheerful guy there ever was. But I really like this song. It's called They Don't Dig for Coal Here Anymore. As I stand and look around this little mining town, my mind goes back to better times before. How Daddy raised a family here with a shovel and a pick, but they don't dig for coal here anymore. This empty lot I stand in was once a boarding house, and I still recall the compound on the floor. And I can almost hear the whistle of a train that used to be, but they don't dig for coal here anymore. No, they don't dig for coal here anymore. There's an empty field where the tipple stood before, and everything that used to be is just a memory, and they don't dig for coal here anymore. Is gone, and they tore down the company store, and they sealed off all the mines at the other end of town, and they don't dig for coal here anymore. Most everyone I know left here many years ago, and they wonder what I still hang around here for. But I just love this little town. She's the sweetest town around. They just don't dig for coal here anymore. No, they don't dig for coal here anymore. There's an empty field where the tipple stood before, and everything that used to be is just a memory, and they don't dig for coal here anymore. No, they don't dig for coal here anymore.
Flippa said, reminds me of Southeast Ohio. A lot of coal mining has shut down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep, it really has. And you know, I'm...
Industry's changing.
Times change and yeah, and all of that. But it always makes me kind of smile. This is as political as I ever get, by the way. When I hear all these people extolling electric cars, but they're charging them off the power grid... which is still mostly burning fossil fuels. So I'm not quite sure what the, other than maybe advances in battery technology, which may eventually wean us off of it, I don't see the point. Anyway, here is a song by Tennessee Ernie Ford.
Oh, goodness, that goes back a bit.
Mm-hmm.
He had an incredible voice. One of the deeper voices I can remember in my...
Yeah, he was a baritone, I guess, if you wanted to, you know, actually wanted to classify it. He had a variety show in the 50s and early 60s.
Tennessee Ernie Ford.
Yeah. The old pea picker, they called him.
Yeah.
and this is a song of his that I really like, and it's called Tell Me You Remember Betty Jean. Betty Jean, do you remember 1982? Before we had the babies, and it was only me and you. You know I can still hear you saying I do. Do you remember Betty Jean? Betty Jean, do you remember when the times got so rough and it was all that we could manage, just to keep from giving up. But somehow we held things together with love. Do you remember Betty Jean? So tell me you haven't forgotten. Tell me you still feel the same. Tell me the years haven't faded your love. Tell me you remember Betty Jean. Betty Jean, do you remember when the kids finally moved and we were back where we started with only me and you? It was just like September 1982. Do you remember Betty Jean? So tell me you haven't forgotten. Tell me you still feel the same. Tell me the years haven't faded your love. Tell me you remember Betty Jean. Tell me the years haven't faded your love. Tell me you remember Betty Jean.
Nice.
I like that song.
Philippa said, well, people don't see as much as they think they do. I'm looking at solar power. I guess she means for...
Right.
For batteries.
And that's the hope, that we can find batteries good enough to support solar and wind generation.
Yeah.
But all these people who are running around in Priuses and Teslas looking down their noses at the rest of us have got a problem that they need to work out. Mm-hmm. In terms of cognitive dissonance. But anyway, let's move past that.
Yes.
Here is a third song by the Statler Brothers. Last one of theirs we're going to do today. And it's called The Class of 57 Had Its Dreams. Tommy is selling used cars, Nancy's fixing hair, Harvey runs a grocery store, and Margaret doesn't care. This happens to me every time on this song. Jerry drives a truck for Sears, Charlotte's on the make, Paul sells life insurance and part-time real estate. Helen is a hostess, Frank works at the mill, Janet teaching grade school and probably always will. Bob works for the city, Jack's in lab research, and Peggy plays organ at the Presbyterian church. And the class of 57 had its dreams. We all thought we'd change the world with our great words and deeds. Or maybe we just thought the world would change to fit our needs. But the class of 57 had its dreams. Betty runs a trailer park, Jan sells Tupperware, Randy's on an insane ward and Mary's on welfare. Charlie took a job with Ford, Joe took Freddie's wife, Charlotte took a millionaire and Freddie took his life. John is big in cattle, Ray is deep in debt, where Mavis finally ended up is anybody's bet. Brenda married Sonny, Linda married me, And the class of all of us is just part of history. And the class of 57 had its dreams. Living life day to day ain't always what it seems. Things get complicated when you get past 18. And the class of 57 had its dreams. The class of 57 had its dreams.
Yeah.
Here's a song that I did before once, and I got a request for it, kind of like the other one like this, and it kind of fits the themes. It's was done by Mary Hopkins. It was her one and only hit back in 1968. It's called "Those Were the Days." Once upon a time there was a tavern where we used to raise a glass or two. Remember how we whiled away the hours? Think of all the great things we would do. Friend, we thought they'd never end. We'd sing and dance forever and a day. We'd live the life we choose. We'd fight and never lose, for we were young and sure to have our way. Da 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 da. Then the busy years went rushing by us. We lost our starry notions on the way. If by chance I'd see you in the tavern, we'd smile at one another and we'd say, those were the days, my friend, we thought they'd never end. We'd sing and dance forever and a day. We'd live the life we'd choose. We'd fight and never lose. Those were the days, oh yes, those were the days. Da 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 da. Die, 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 die. Just tonight I stood before the tavern. Nothing seemed the way it used to be. In the glass I saw a strange reflection. Was that lonely fellow really me? Those were the days, my friend, we thought they'd never end. We'd sing and dance forever and a day. We'd live the life we'd choose. We'd fight and never lose. Those were the days, oh yes, those were the days. Die, 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 die. Through the door there came familiar laughter. I saw your face and heard you call my name. Oh, my friend, we're older but no wiser, for in our hearts the dreams are still the same. Those were the days, my friend, we thought they'd never end. We'd sing and dance forever and a day. We'd live the life we choose, we'd fight and never lose. Those were the days, oh yes, those were the days. Die, 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 die. Da 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 da.
Reference to the last song about the class 57 and the dreams they had.
Yeah.
Ivan said, that is one dysfunctional class.
Yeah. Yeah, none of them turned out too good, did they?
No.
I never thought of it that way.
I like that last one. Those were the days. I remember when that came out. Just loved that song.
Yeah.
It's a good song.
It's very haunting.
Yes.
I really like it. I can almost play it, too, which is
fun.
Okay.
Flip said old favorite, definitely.
Yeah. I really like that one. Here is a third and final song we're going to do today by the Bellamy Brothers. This one is called Kids of the Baby Boom. Our daddies won the war and they came back to our moms. Gave them so much love that all us kids were born. We all grew up on Mickey Mouse and hula hoops. And bought new pickup trucks and BMWs. We watched John Kennedy die one afternoon. Kids of the baby boom. It was a time of new prosperity in the USA. And all the fortunate offspring didn't have to pay. We had sympathy for the devil and the Rolling Stones. We got a little older, we found Haggard and Jones. A generation screaming for more room. Kids of the baby boom. Kids of the baby boom. We have freedom, we have money. The baby boom. Here in the land of milk and honey, counting our chickens way too soon. Kids of the baby boom. We all can run computers and we all can dance. We all have Calvin Klein written on our underpants. And at 6 o'clock, like robots, we turn on the news. Watch those third world countries deal out more abuse. Remember the first man on the moon. Kids of the baby boom. Kids of the baby boom. We have freedom, we have money. The baby boom. Here in the land of milk and honey. Counting our chickens way too soon. Kids of the baby boom. Our lives are in a capsule they sent to the stars. Our children look at us as though we came from Mars. The farms are disappearing and the skies turn black. We're a country full of takers, never giving back. And we never think about what we consume. Kids of the baby boom. Kids of the baby boom. We have freedom, we have money. The baby boom. Here in the land of milk and honey. Counting our chickens way too soon. Kids of the baby boom. Our optimism mingles with our doom. Kids of the baby boom.
Wow.
That'll cheer you right up on it.
Ivan said, folks, donate to George's MLAG fund. We want to hear him on the open stage.
Thank you, Ivan. I meant to mention that. I'm raising money to go to MLAG. I'm looking at every opportunity that I can get to do that. Every penny you donate will go to that. It won't be spent for anything else other than to get me to MLAG. And I really want to go. And with your help, we'll get there. I'm going to fly to Detroit, and then Dan Woking, who I consider to be my little brother, he's actually Linda's brother, yeah, and I are going to drive, well, he's going to drive, I'm going to ride,
yeah, that's good.
up to MLAG, and he's going to see to it that I get around and go all the places I need to go and everything.
That's Mountain Laurel Autoharp.
Mountain Laurel
Autoharp
Gathering is what that stands for. If you go to paypal.com and put money in autoharp.down.home@gmail.com, it's in the intro to this post, and it should be in blue
on the bottom of the screen. I hope you can see it there.
We don't know. That's an experiment that we tried.
We're hoping it's there. Dan said, you can help drive if you want.
No, thanks. I want to get there. The one and only time I drove a car, I almost got arrested for drunk driving, but I was forgiven because I had a heart attack victim in the car. I went squirrel hunting with a guy, a friend of my father's. I love to go squirrel hunting because you sit and you're very quiet and you wait for squirrels to come by and then you kill them and you eat them for breakfast with gravy and biscuits.
And they're good too.
And I could spot the squirrels. But anyway, this old gentleman and I went one day, and I'd been with him before, and he had some kind of a spell. And he was, I don't know if it was a heart attack or a stroke or exactly what, but he just wasn't all there. And we were in an area where I had ridden my horse a lot. So I knew all the roads and everything really, really well. And I knew where we were. And I put him in the car, and the roads were all dirt and gravel. So I drove down the road, and I listened very carefully, okay? And when the right side tires got into the loose gravel, I'd correct left because I figured I was on the right edge of the road. And when the left side tires hit gravel, I'd correct right because I figured I was either on the other side of the road or at the center where the gravel collects. So I'm going down the road at, 15, 20 miles an hour in a series of Z's and W's. And we were traveling through, we weren't hunting in, but we were traveling through a state forest, and a ranger stopped me. And, boy, I locked those brakes up. He almost rear-ended us. I was so happy to see anybody.
Yeah.
And he came, he had an attitude to begin with. And I said, look, you can arrest me or do whatever you want to me later, but my friend is seriously ill. And we were squirrel hunting back there, and it's the only way I could get him out. And he said, man, I thought you were the drunkest driver I'd ever pulled over. He said, you wouldn't believe how you were going down the road, but you were headed right. And they flew in a helicopter, and they medevaced the guy, and he lived a number of years past that, but that was the only experience I ever had driving a car where I didn't have sighted help, and I'd just soon not repeat that.
No, Nan said you can see the, yes, it is there.
Oh, good.
And Ivan said, we want Lynn, too. Oh, that was very sweet.
Yeah.
But I'll probably keep the home fires burning. And
somebody's got to take care of the dogs and and the house and everything. But we'll see. Maybe I can talk her into it.
Ivan said on the lettering, it's there but hard to read, would be better in white. And Philippa said, can see the blue lettering just fine. I'm afraid if we did it in white, part of it would disappear. With the blue, there's a little bit of contrast, so you can still see. Well, anyway, we're experimenting, and thank you for the input.
Yeah, we appreciate the feedback. It depends on what kind of device
that might be part of it, too.
You're watching it on.
Yeah.
Here is a song that reflects the experience of a lot of, at least, American boys, and I'm sure boys everywhere. It's called Drive. It's painted red, the stripe was white, 18 feet from bow to stern light. Second hand from a dealer in Atlanta, I rode up with Daddy when he went there to get her. Put on a shine, put on the motor, built out of love and made for the water. We ran her for years till the transom got rotten. Piece of my childhood that can never be forgotten. It was just an old plywood boat with a 75 Johnson with electric choke. A young boy, two hands on the wheel. I can't replace the way it made me feel. And I would turn her sharp and I would make it wide. He'd say, you can't beat the way an old wood boat rides. It was just a little lake across the Alabama line, but I was king of the ocean when Daddy let me drive. It's an old half-ton short bed Ford. My uncle bought it new in 64. Daddy got it right, 'cause the engine was smoking, couple burnt valves, and he had it going. He led me drive her when we haul off a load to a dirt strip where we dump trash off a thigpen road. I'd sit up on the seat, stretch my feet out to the pedals, smiling like a hero who just received his medals. It was just an old hand-me-down Ford with three on the column and a dent in the door. A young boy, two hands on the wheel. I can't replace the way it made me feel. And I would press that clutch, keep it right. A little slower, son, now you're doing just fine. It was just a dirt road with trash on each side, but I was Mario Andretti when Daddy let me drive. I'm all grown up now, three daughters of my own. I let them drive my old Jeep across the pasture at our home. Maybe someday they'll reach back in their file and pull out that old memory and think of me and smile, and they'll say, it was just an old worn-out Jeep with rusty old floorboards, hot on my feet. A young girl, two hands on the wheel. I can't replace the way it made me feel. And he'd say, turn it left, steer it right. Straighten up, girl, now you're doing just fine. It was just a little valley by the river where we'd ride, but I was high on a mountain when Daddy let me drive. When Daddy let me drive. Oh, he let me drive. It was just an old plywood boat with a 75 Johnson with electric choke.
Wow. Nan said very nice on that. And I have a
comment
from Ziggy, but what about the second camera for Lynn?
That is coming.
Yes, it's on the way.
We just haven't received it yet. We do have that in process, and we're gonna get her on here somehow.
And I took time off this week because I was painting, so I didn't have a song.
Yeah, she didn't have a song this week.
This week.
She is painting a portrait of Lulu.
Yes.
Which we are going to give to her breeders, the people that we got her from.
Right.
So that they can tell other people that one of their dogs actually got to be a guide dog and how good she was. And who knows, maybe, because this is a place that sells sporting dogs. And you know how people are about their dogs. And it might drum up some business for Lynn. She might become...
I might get some
in demand and have to raise money herself to go to some of these dog shows and paint dogs.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Amber said as far as the print, we could make it taller. And George Solomon. Hi, George.
Hi.
And Lynn. Good
Hi,
to
George.
Hear you again.
Yes, indeed. And welcome back, sir.
He said blue is okay and shows up pretty well. And then Ivan came back and said, take it from a graphic designer. Look how bright the white comments are. There is more than enough contrast in the video area to employ white. So
we'll try it, Ivan.
Yes.
We sure will. We can also play with things like opacity.
Yes.
And I don't know which, you know, how to... We'll play with it. We just discovered we could do this like 2 days ago.
Right.
And
so we're still...
Amber was here. Lynn is not really technical, and this
right.
is absolutely
so
beyond
helping.
My purview because you have to be able to see to adjust it. So, you know, we didn't have a lot of time to work on it, but we're sure going to take everybody's advice into account. And we'll get together and see if we can brighten it up somehow.
Amber said, love that song. Well done.
Thank you.
Yeah. Daddy Let Me Drive. And Flip said, reminds me of back in Carmel, California at a summer camp the summer before Kennedy was shot. Camp master taught me to drive a tractor. Wow. And then Ivan says, second camera. Great. Yeah, we're looking forward to doing that. So you can have me on there too. Right now I'm just out there in the out there.
Just a voice.
A voice in the out there.
A faceless face. Voice. I can't get her to step in front of this camera and let everybody see what she looks like. So.
I don't.
Knowing that she didn't expect to be on camera, so I'm sure she'd want to dress
up
a little bit.
A little
yeah,
not
absolutely.
Well, I just can't figure out, because of the delay, I could stand in front of the camera and you're looking at my shoulder or... my ear or something, and I wouldn't know, you know.
You switch over to the streaming encoder and then step over here and then switch back.
Oh, and Ivan said, I'd be happy to advise you anytime. Appreciate that.
Yeah, we might arrange a time when, you know, we'll do a live stream and help.
And
get
some help there.
We use all the help we get, for sure. I appreciate that very much, and we'll definitely take you up on that. All right.
He's happy to advise, he said.
The time is 2:46 p.m.
Okay.
Yeah, we're getting close to the
hour. We're running out of time. Oh, no. I hate that. Look forward to doing this, and then it has to end. Anyway, we're not quite done yet, folks. Hang in there. this is another Judd Strunk song. I really like this guy. He is from Maine. And he does interesting music. He had one hit that a lot of people did. It was called Daisy a Day. I did it on one of the other shows. This song by him that was recorded by him in the 1970s is called The Next Door Neighbor's Kid. And I'm singing it in honor of my best friend in all the world, Steve Randazzo. We weren't next door neighbors. He lived a street over from me. But he was my best bud all the way until he passed away of stomach cancer in 1993. He's the guy who made it possible for me to move to Alabama, which is, I always wanted to live in the South, and he made that happen. We were best friends, and we got into everything. Look, if we didn't do it, there were only two reasons why we didn't do something. Either we couldn't figure out a way not to get in trouble, or we didn't think of it. Other than that, we did the craziest things in creation. We created a UFO scare one time. Actually succeeded at making a high explosive one time and then couldn't figure out what the hell to do with it. We, you know, like I say, if we didn't do it, it was because we didn't think of it. So this is for you, Steve, wherever you are. And it's called The Next Door Neighbor's Kid. I recall a bat and ball, the games that we would play. Climbing trees, shooting peas at the Saturday matinee. Playing pool, skipping school, the crazy things we did. I had a ball and I did it all with the next door neighbor's kid. Later on, the junior prom when we got drunk as hell. We drove that old Ford off the road, I swore I'd never tell. He took us to the cellar, where he had some homebrew hid. I said, hey, you're really something, you're the next door neighbor's kid. I recall a bat and ball, games that we would play. Climbing trees, shooting peas at the Saturday matinee. Fishing pole, the swimming hole, the crazy things we did. We did it all and I had a ball with the next door neighbor's kid. Then I went my way, he went his with a rifle and a pack. Only thing of it was they shot him in the back. But I'll bet his boys can ride and hide the way their daddy did. I got a prayer, please take care of the next door neighbor's kid. I recall a bat and ball, the games we would play. Climbing trees, shooting peas at the Saturday matinee. Playing pool, skipping school, the crazy things we did. I did it all and I had a ball with the next door neighbor's kid. I did it all and I had a ball with the next door neighbor's kid.
Philip said shopping carts across parking lots.
Yeah.
Somebody has heard the story. Yes.
A bag of concrete, you know, like not set, just powdered concrete, thrown from the window of a car because somebody was tailgating us. Cured them of that real quick. They slowed way down, and then what did they do? They hit their windshield washers. Bad idea.
Oh, no.
They had to pull over and stop.
Oh, dear. Ziggy said, I've got one Judd Strunk LP, a semi-reformed tequila-crazed gypsy looks back. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
Oh, 1977.
Oh, man. I can't get enough Judd Strunk. Can't get enough Judd Strunk. Here's a bonus. We got a few minutes left here. I did this one once before too. J.A. Butterfield and George Washington Johnson wrote this many years ago. It's called When You and I Were Young, Maggie. I wander today to the hill, Maggie, and to watch the scene below. The creek and the rusty old mill, Maggie, as we sat in the long, long ago. The green grove is gone from the hill, Maggie, where first the daisy sprung. The rusty old mill is now still, Maggie, when you and I were young. A city so silent and lone, Maggie, where the young and the gay and the best, in polished white mansions of stone, Maggie, where each finds a place of rest. It's built where the birds used to play, Maggie, and join in the songs that were sung, but we sang as gay as they, Maggie, when you and I were young. Now I am feeble with age, Maggie, my step less lively than then. My face is a well-written page, Maggie, and time all along held the pen. They say we are aged and gray, Maggie, like the spray from the white breakers flung. But to me you're as fair as you were, Maggie, when you and I were young. When you, okay. And now we are aged and gray, Maggie, and the trials of life are nearly done. Let us sing of the days that are gone, Maggie, when you and I were young. When you and I were young.
Nan said, thanks for some wonderful songs. And Ziggy said, at several occasions during the concert, I thought, what a wonderful voice you have, George, and how so beautifully you sing.
Thank you. Thank you, Ziggy. Thank you, Nan.
I agree.
Well, we do have time for another song. Is there anything anyone would like to hear me butcher today? Well, late last night in a kettle of fish, I was having a glass of beer, when up comes a rounder by the name of Sam, who'd lately been seen around here. He gives me a howdy and he buys me a drink and he calls me by my name. Said some of the boys are just a-waiting upstairs, would you like to have a poker game? There were four or five fellas around the table upstairs, the smoke was thick as sin. They took my coat and they pulled up a chair and they proceeded to deal me in. I started in winning with the very first hand, and I kept on winning for a while. Had money in my pockets and money in my shoes, money in a great big pile. But it's, oh Lordy, don't you see, this old stud poker be the ruin of me. You gotta get ready to shed some blood when the name of the game is stud. You know, I kept on winning for an hour or more, and the boys were feeling low. I was looking like a winner and feeling like a sinner, and I just about had their dough. I caught a pair of aces on the very last hand, and I bet my whole bankroll. But Sammy had a pair of deuces on the deck and another deuce in the hole. And it's, oh Lordy, don't you see, this old stud poker be the ruin of me. You gotta get ready to shed some blood when the name of the game is stud. You know, I lost every penny that I had in the world. I lost my last red cent. Now my old woman ain't talking to me, and the landlord wants his rent. I know I had it coming, and it sure enough did, and I've only got myself to blame. But my fingers keep itching, and I keep on twitching just to find another poker game. And it's, oh Lordy, don't you see, this old stud poker be the ruin of me. You gotta get ready to shed some blood when the name of the game is stud.
Ivan said, another great program, folks. Looking forward to the next one.
Indeed. Well, thank you all for coming.
Thank you, thank you.
We really appreciate it. Can't wait to see you next time. Tell your friends about us. And like I say, if you can afford to put a buck or two in our tip jar for MLAG, we would really appreciate it. Now it's time to say goodbye to George and all his kin. We'd sure like to thank you folks for kindly dropping in. We're all invited back again to this locality to have a heaping helping of our hospitality. Home style, that is. Set a spell. Take your shoes off. Y'all come back now here.
Robert said, truly amazing collection you've brought to us today. Thank you, and I will be able to make at least a small contribution to help you get to Mountain Laurel.
Oh, thank you, Robert. Every little bit helps, and we're getting there. I really appreciate it, and I'm glad you came to see us today. I'm glad everybody stopped by.
Nan said, loved it, and Robert added, precious memories, or did I miss it today? That was the... Precious memories.
Precious memories. That's a good idea. We need to... I will... I'll tell you what, Robert. I will have it for you next show.
Yeah.
2 weeks from now. And the theme of that, I think, is going to be country comedy.
Yes.
So it's going to be real corny. we'll also do at least one song in remembrance of 9/11. Which
yes.
Would be on the Friday after the show. Yes. But it's going to be a good show. I've already got most of it picked out, and I will add that song to the list.
Precious memories.
I certainly will. Precious memories.
Yes. And Ziggy said, thanks, George and Lynn, for another lovely concert. Bruce Anderson, thank you from Vermont.
Hey, Bruce. Welcome.
Good to see you.
Good to there see you.
So glad you guys stopped by today. We have had a wonderful time.
We have. We really look forward to these.
Oh, yeah.
And I can't wait to see you all again.
I ended it. I accidentally ended it.
No, that's fine. That's perfect. That's what...